On this episode of Don't Tell the Bride, Brian and LT are tying the knot. But this wedding will be like nothing you've ever seen, because it's being planned by the person you'd least expect. The groom. We've given Brian $25,000 to spend, but just 3 short weeks to plan the entire wedding.
Oh, my stomach.
With absolutely no input from his bride.
Wow.
Not having any say is driving me insane.
And only one source of support, his best man.
Oh, what questions am I supposed to ask?
That's your wedding, you ask me.
Brian's biggest hurdle? His inability to make a single decision.
Maybe we select the golf guys to make the decision for us.
And the millions of options leave him in shock.
There we go.
Brian picks pink for the bridesmaids and has them seeing red.
This is the dress.
Is it that color?
And can LT trust Brian after the bachelorette bowling party is a bust?
This has to be a joke.
Right.
Can this man give this woman,
he may see Bridezilla come out,
the wedding of her dreams?
If they're not what I like, then I'm out the door.
Brian and LT are hopelessly in love. They've been together for 3 years and engaged for the past 7 months.
She started MySpace stalking me. So I just figured at that time I had her, so it was time for me to reel her in.
The first date, he drove me insane. He couldn't decide what he wanted to eat. When he finally decided, he then got up and found the waiter and changed his order again.
That's exactly what happened. I've got a surprise for you.
Oh,
here you go.
Thank you. He makes me laugh. Our personalities are so different that it works.
Roses,
thank you.
Now make my sandwich.
And make your sandwich.
This is Brian. I'm a real estate professional. I buy and sell houses for a living. It is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath. Obviously, we've had a decline in the market. We haven't gotten married yet because we were saving up money. I'll tell you something. Bye-bye. Things aren't like the way they used to be, but we're hoping for a turnaround. Come on, Obama.
I am definitely high maintenance. I like things a certain way. I just want it to be nice and elegant.
I think a theme wedding would be awesome.
If I showed up at my wedding and it was not a traditional theme, I probably would cry. I would like a 4-tier cake, a signature drink.
I'm pretty much winging it.
A harpist playing.
I do things on the fly, so I might think of something the day of the wedding.
The dress and my hair are the most important things to me, and it's a deal breaker. If they're not what I like, then I'm out the door.
It's real simple. Get a venue, get some food, listen to some music, go home and have fun, you know?
For the next 3 weeks, LT and Brian won't be allowed to communicate. And the next time they see each other, it will be at the altar. Unless, of course, Brian fails to get it done without LT's help.
Where's my toothpaste case? The light blue one? Oh, man, I don't know where nothing is.
Do you want me to come look?
I got this, woman.
I can come and grab it.
Yeah, I think I need you to find it. Oh, there it goes. I just wanted to give you a little test.
Right, I told you to check here first.
For LT's sake, let's hope planning a wedding is easier for Brian than finding his toothpaste case.
Don't worry about anything, all right? So, I know how you are. I know you like to control everything sometimes, but you'll be okay on this one. Just trust me on this, all right?
Not having any say in the wedding, the whole process, is driving me insane. I am very, very nervous. Seeing him get in the car and drive off just made the situation more real to me. I hope that Brian gets it right. I hope that he doesn't disappoint me.